Hi, welcome, hi.
Hi, welcome to the channel of love. Not hi guys, just hi. Listen, this is my fourth attempt at getting you a reading out. And I'm sitting here and I'm just like, I really just don't know what cards to use. Because I've pulled three different stories and I'm going to my original plan. Archangel Power Tarot cards. So hi guys, welcome to the channel of love. It's Friday. I've got the Friday feeling, but there's lots of feelings that are floating around. So I would just like to bring you a message. Queen of Raphael, kind, understanding, giving, and psychic. Follow your heart, a love of home and family, trustworthy psychic information. The Page of Ariel, reliable, clever, educated, balanced. An excellent opportunity will be offered to you, scholarships or the pursuit of education. And it's time to get to work. And the Nine of Gabriel, stay determined and move forward. Be prepared for any possibility. Environmental activism. It's a very interesting energy coming through. It kind of makes sense to the previous three stories now. Eight of Ariel, take great pride in your excellent work. Practice makes perfect. Consider getting additional education or training. And the Magician, just like that. You can manifest the life you want. What you need will magically appear. Successful beginnings. A Six of Gabriel, lovely energy. Congratulations, you've done a wonderful job. Time to move on to the next projects, awards, scholarships or promotions. This story here is regarding a divine masculine that did have another partner. The good news is this partner's now healed and they're happy to move on and let the divine masculine be free. They're acting kind, understanding, giving, and they're psychic. So they've actually gone through their own spiritual awakening and they can see that it's time they reclaim their happiness. They're following their heart, a love of home and family, and trustworthy psychic information. This feminine here is very happy now, indicating that before she was very unstable. Okay, and I feel this masculine had concerns about leaving this feminine in that condition, but he's free now to leave. Here she is. The Page of Ariel is the divine feminine's energy. Reliable, clever, educated and balanced. An excellent opportunity will be offered to you. Scholarships or the pursuit of education. Time to get to work. This is you really being able to get to work on your mission now. It's more about you feeling comfortable. About being able to do so. Then we had the masculine. The divine masculine that I felt was joining you. Stay determined and move forward. Be prepared for any possibility. Environmental activism. That's the masculine there stepping into his purpose. I actually feel where the feminine here, all the education that you've acquired, knowledge, but it's saying education. The divine masculine now is like on catch up, but I feel he's doing it in the physical and spiritual at the same time. He's learning a lot. He's able to learn a lot now because his headspace is clear. And we have the Magician. Sorry, it says here, take great pride in your excellent work. Practice makes perfect. Consider getting additional education or training. And I feel it's you that here becoming two for that additional education and training, seeing as you've kind of, I don't know, it's like you have a degree. A decree was coming through, though. We have the magician. You can manifest the life you want, what you need, or magically appear successful beginnings. And it's just like that. That's how things can come together. Bottom of the deck is Six of Gabriel. The masculine's here. Congratulations, you've done a wonderful job. It's time to move on to the next projects, awards, scholarships, or promotions. Becoming the divine masculine now and being free and able to do so comfortably, confidently. We'll go to the angels and ancestors. I'm sticking to the original plan, which was just three decks of cards. I didn't use any of these cards in the first three readings I tried to do. Let's have a look and see what your angels and ancestors would like to say. Peacekeeper, let go of the need to be right. Choose peace and happiness over the need to be right. I actually feel that's exactly what this energy has done, this Queen of Cups here. The Peacekeeper is a wise Native American woman who has been influenced by white buffalo woman. She holds a peace pipe, which is emblematic of surrounding. Should we just start again? The Peacekeeper is a wise Native American woman who has been influenced by white buffalo woman. She holds a peace pipe, which is emblematic of surrendering, the need to fight and offering harmony instead. She is a soul who knows what it's like to feel under threat and to stand up for what she believes in and what is right. Her medicine helps you to take the higher road in every situation, even if you are under pressure to make a quick decision. It is a reminder that within your hands lies the power to make the right choice for all involved. I actually feel, Divine Feminine, you've had an influence on everyone. Your energy has. Even on the karmic energy here. You may be feeling on edge due to a stressful situation. There's a warrior within you that wants to rise up, prove your point and get the truth across. But you're being reminded by ancestor wisdom that truth will always be revealed in the end. It's more important at this time to avoid arguments or heated discussions where you know you'll be fighting a losing battle. There is much more power in choosing to move forward from a higher perspective. This will allow you to connect deeply to the guidance within and the intuition that will lead you towards the healing of the whole situation, along with any wounds it may have inflicted on you. Choose peace. You know it's calling you. I feel your peaceful presence, Divine Feminine, has rubbed off onto the Divine Masculine. This is very much about how you respond. And it's also rubbed off onto this karmic energy. Lovely energy. Let's end with a Mother Mary Oracle card. Okay. I feel extremely sniffly all of a sudden. Let's have a look at the cards. The card is Our Lady with the Moon at her feet. Card number 36. I have heard your heart prayers. I have heard you calling to me silently in suffering, wanting to let go and grow, and finding that despite all your effort, still you must endure. It is as if you are sinking when you want to rise, falling when you want to fly. I come to you now with the moon at my feet and ask you to put your trust in me. I will help you outgrow that which no longer serves, so that what you struggle to attain now, through effort, in time will come naturally to you. Have faith. What you want is possible, and I will help you get there. The power of habitual consciousness is mighty indeed. Even if we know we want to change, and even if we have taken practical steps to change, the challenge of sustaining ourselves in a new way without falling back into old emotional or psychological patterns can be extremely difficult. This is especially so if what you are seeking to change has been part of your core wounding this lifetime, becoming a habit that seems impossible to break, no matter how much you may want to do so. There is a force of gravity that works upon us in this world, not only physically, but emotionally and psychologically as well. It is why, despite tremendous desire and effort, change can be difficult most times, and sometimes even seem impossible at other times. To be able to grow in life requires that we are able to intelligently respond to the challenges that are a natural part of being human. Sometimes those challenges will be self-created and we will want to let them go. These might include coping mechanisms that aren't really helpful for us, such as addictions or shutting people out and withdrawing into a solitude of suffering or disassociating through compulsive behaviours that undermine our self-esteem and emotional or even financial well-being. Sometimes the challenges will be circumstances imposed upon us by time or by others, and we cannot control that situation and need to find a way not only to bear it, but perhaps even, if we are feeling bold, to transform it from something negative or frustrating into an opportunity to do things differently and feel more freedom. What is needed for transformation, for healthy growth, is strength, patience, and an ability to respond intelligently to life's challenges, with a view to making them work for your own personal growth. However, sometimes all of this is just not enough. Sometimes we move this way and that, we wait, we apply ourselves, we take practical steps, and still, despite our best intentions, we may feel ourselves sliding backwards into old habits, old patterns of thinking or being, old emotional patterns. We might not even see them as patterns. We might instead just think that is the way life is, and there is nothing we can do about it. But this is not true at all. In such instances, what is needed is the loving intervention and assistance of a being that is more powerful than the gravity that we are unable to counter through our efforts alone. There is no shame in this. In fact, there is wisdom in recognizing when help is needed and in accepting it. Like a growing plant that needs a trellis until it has stabilized itself, so too do we humans need divine support at times along our path as we are mastering new levels of consciousness, new habits, and new ways of being. If it was easy, everyone would be living exactly as they wanted to be living without any struggle. Clearly, this is not happening in the world as often as we may wish. The Divine Mother will help us move through our struggles if only we allow her to do so. Her being, her love, is more powerful then our greatest forces of habitual consciousness and behaviour. The miracles of her healing can transform even the most stubborn pessimist into an active optimist. Our Lady with the Moon at her feet comes to us when we are attempting to outgrow, through inspiration, hope, love, bold spiritual daring, or big dreams, that which seems to be holding us back or impossible to change. She tells us that through her intervention, we can find the support that we need as we face the challenges of growth, and she will lend us her power to be able to reach for that star, which without her would perhaps be somewhat beyond our reach, for now at least. She also tells us that if we are feeling boxed in or diverted from our higher purpose in life, she will help us. She asks us to pray to her and to know that what is now is not what must always be. Transformation and healing is possible, but you must trust her. You must place more faith in her than in what appears to be an insolvable or reoccurring difficulty. This oracle is a wild card in the deck, in that it empowers and strengthens any other message that you receive. If you receive this card on its own, it is enough. But if you choose another card as well, this card asks you to pay extra special attention to the guidance in the other card you choose. The following healing process will help you connect with Our Lady and receive her beneficial help. Okay, the healing process and affirmation. Sense or perceive that it is darkest night all around you. Quiet, open space extends around in all directions. You become aware of a magnificent holy woman lit up like a star in the night sky. She stands with bare feet upon a crescent moon. You notice the moon under her feet. Perhaps you cannot help but look at it. It has a strange glow and is fascinating, mysterious. You then become aware of the feet of the Holy Woman. As you gaze at her feet, the dark night and the moon fade away, and you are aware of her feet glowing radiantly. A white sun burns in each foot. The light and warmth of those suns shines on you. Imagine you can feel or intend to receive the light and warmth of those suns on your face, your body, all the way into your heart. And when you are ready, complete your process with the following healing affirmation, said aloud if possible, with feeling from the heart. Holy Mother Mary, Our Lady with the Moon at her feet, protect me with your heavenly grace. Where I would stumble, your love uplifts me. Where I would fail to see, your love opens the eye in my heart and gives me vision. Where I might fail, you ensure success. Together I and all beings succeed in healing growth. I open and surrender into your tender blessing and merciful grace, that I will fulfill my divine destiny. Page number 155. It said here, this oracle is a wild card in the deck, in that it empowers and strengthens any other message that you receive. If you receive this card on its own, it is enough. But if you choose another card as well, this card asks you to pay extra special attention to the guidance on the other card you choose. And of course, I'm going to choose an oracle card, the Magical Mermaids and Dolphins oracle card. Pay extra special attention to this message, guys. Three cards. So soulmate relationship is the first card. New romance with a spiritual basis is here for you now. Let's read the message. Remember to breathe. I felt myself holding my breath then. Your desire to be in a great love relationship has manifested, and you're being guided to create or maintain that situation right now. This relationship has a deep spiritual basis, with both partners having true faith and profound beliefs. You and your partner share similar spiritual concepts and are open-minded when it comes to learning about and implementing new practices. This partnership flows to you naturally right now. However, if you worry about or try to force the situation to happen, you could slow the results. It's important for you to enjoy the process leading up to your desired outcome. Dance with the movement that your manifestations have created for you. Attract your partner through your warm and relaxed demeanor, and know that heaven is taking care of all the details for both of you. And in the meantime, dream big. Let go of small thoughts about yourself. See yourself succeeding. In the past, you may have seen yourself as insignificant. This card asks you to release any thoughts or feelings of inferiority. Truly believe that you are utterly qualified for any endeavour you can dream about. Write down a list of your fears about moving forward, and then drown those fears by putting the paper into a bucket or large bowl of water. Then take a cleansing shower, bath or swim. The water seals your new way of seeing yourself, as you are in truth an equal to all other children of God. So those were the two cards that came out, and then there was a third card. Pay special attention. Accept heaven's help. You pray for help, so get out of the way and let heaven help you. You've asked, what should I do next? This card responds, trust that your prayers have been heard and answered. Simply rest and retreat for now. After all, you prayed for divine intervention, so step aside and let heaven intervene, as this is the help you prayed for. You can assist the process initiated by your prayers through quiet contemplation. Ask heaven to give you very clear, easily understandable guidance, letting you know if you need to take any action. In the meantime, enjoy knowing your angels and guides surround you and your situation with loving care. What a beautiful message, guys. Okay, I feel like I want to end with one more. The journey of love. We have the journey of love. It's like we have the journey of love before us. I'm in the mood for dancing, romancing. Ooh, I'm giving it all tonight, dancing. Let's have a look at the journey of love. Oh, we've got two cards. The first card is Knowing Without Knowing, card number 41. Sometimes the heart knows in a way that the concrete mind and memory cannot. We feel something that we cannot quite express. Perhaps others are quick to dismiss it as a meaningless whimsy or irrationality. Yet that feeling beyond the mind's capacity to fully perceive is the ancient truth of your greater self reaching through time and space to connect with you. Like a phone line extending from a more ancient place in the world, you can hear it crackle perhaps. Not the clearest perception, yet you can also sense the love travelling along that telephone line. The things that you feel and that do not appear to make sense are the things to trust most now. You are being guided by a force far greater than your own mind. An ancient divine brilliance is reaching to you, communicating with you. You may not hear or understand it with clarity as yet, but you can feel it. Trust what you feel. This oracle speaks to you of the opening up of your higher mind, of the part of your intelligence that can dialogue directly with the forces of divine guidance and creation. These forces use symbols, abstract communications through dreams and visions, through impulses that circumvent your conscious mind and have words streaming out of your mouth or flowing through your mind that you have not created of your own volition. Someone speaks to you and you respond with words that you feel you are hearing for the first time as they pour out your mouth. Whose words are these, you wonder? It is your ancient self that speaks. Trust the strange and mysterious at this time. It is another way, an ancient way of wisdom that you are tapping into now. Enjoy this new sacred connection unfolding. This oracle is also confirmation that you have relationships around you now and continuing to come to you that are from times long past, karmic connections that will take you further on your journey of love. Not that you will take, but will take you further on your journey of love. Here's the poem. I have been here before. Aromas open the doors. I walk through knowing. And the final card is the temple. Card number 59. This is very much about being able to tap into your clairaudience, being able to hear. You might think you're hearing things. You are. Those are the things to trust in at this time, guys. The temple. The lover and the beloved meet in sacred space. They take respite from cares of the world, entering into sanctuary where only they exist. You are in need of this. Meditation, making love, connection and dance, intimacy and surrender into the moment. Your body and soul need to enter into the temple and participate in sacred ceremony. Choose to gift this to yourself. Set aside time. Turn off the computer and mobile telephone. Turn on music and set the light in. Be in the present moment. Do you remember your body? Ah, yes, here it is. Can you be in its temple with presence and delight? This oracle brings guidance to take time out to smell the flowers, savour the pleasures of life, and renew your connection to the inner lover. Your sensuality wants to come out and play. You are encouraged to explore scent, touch, taste and feeling. You are encouraged to play with colour. What moves you? What brings you into connection with yourself in this moment again? It is the wholeness of divine self-connection in sacred space that will best nourish you now. All I can hear is it's time for you to give yourself a little stroke. Love should be given as it is received. On this day I grant you the love of 1,000 mountain streams and the pleasure of a handful and the pleasure of 100 bleats from a newborn baby fawn, for I too cry for love, and like the fawn I cry with the hunger of being alive. And on this day I cry for the happiness of giving and the warmth of receiving and the softness of your gentle touch. It is moments like these when I smile for the someone who will always care. Beautiful message, guys. I'll catch up with you guys soon. Until then, take care. Much love. Bye for now.